Neanderthals, Dr. Seuss, Mr. Potato Head, oh my. I'm SE Cupp. Welcome to Unfiltered. Now, in case you've been too busy paying attention to other things, say, surviving a global pandemic, you might not be aware that these are actually the things threatening to ruin American life as we know it. That's right, an ice age species of human that went extinct 40,000 years ago. A wildly popular series of children's books spanning the mid-20th century, and a starchy tuber-turned-dress-up toy from the 50s are all cause for all-caps outrage. These were the stories dominating Republican circles and right-wing media the past 2 weeks, proving we are quite possibly living in the stupidest of times. On just one day this week, Fox News mentioned Dr. Seuss 85 times in 12 hours. Last week, while Congress was attempting to pass a sorely needed coronavirus bill, Fox was obsessing over Mr. Potato Head, mentioning the root vegetable toy at least 35 times on Fox News and Fox Business combined. And Neanderthals haven't seen as good a week since the Pleistocene, with an actual member of Congress running to their defense. What's this all about? I'm genuinely loathe to tell you. It's frankly embarrassing that the party of Lincoln has devolved to this, but here's the Cliff's Notes version. Okay, the company that controls the Seuss catalog decided, on its own, to pull six of his many dozen books because they contain racist portrayals of Asians and Africans. That's right, they decided to modernize, as it were. No one came for them. No one demanded we cancel Green Eggs and Ham. They made a business decision. It's called the free market, I'm told. That didn't stop right-wing culture warriors from hyperventilating. Megyn Kelly tweeted a meme that said, "Imagine living in a nation where Cardi B wins Song of the Year, yet the Cat in the Hat is deemed inappropriate content." "This about sums things up," she tweeted. "Except no, it doesn't. Just factually, Billie Eilish won Song of the Year in 2020. Cardi B isn't even nominated this year. And The Cat in the Hat was not one of the books being pulled." But hey, the culture wars, they don't care about your facts, only feelings of outrage. Another right-wing outlet circulated a post headlined, "The experts have finally come for Dr. Seuss, for our childhoods, and for our children." I'm not kidding. Over to Mr. Potato Head, which I never thought I'd say. Hasbro announced in February it was dropping the Mr. and Mrs. from the toy, eventually clarifying that Mr. and Mrs. Potato Head toys would still be on the shelves, but a gender-neutral Potato Head toy would also be made available. Again, a Hasbro decision that it felt was best for its brand. At CPAC, Florida's own Hasbro Florida rep Matt Gates lamented, "The new Potato Head was, gasp, America's first transgender doll. Hide your kids." And Neanderthals are back in the news after President Joe Biden said, in regards to Texas and Mississippi lifting its mask mandates, "The last thing we need is Neanderthal thinking that in the meantime, everything's fine. Take off your mask. Forget it." Now, I didn't know Neanderthals had a lobby, but they do, and her name is Marsha Blackburn. The Tennessee senator went on Fox Business to defend the poor, oppressed, extinct class, insisting, in the present tense, Neanderthals are hunter-gatherers. They're protectors of their family. They are resilient. They are resourceful. I mean, they're not so resilient. Meanwhile, here's what else is going on. U.S. deaths due to COVID have topped 520,000. Healthcare professionals are worried about spikes after the spring break vacation weeks. The federal government is working to distribute millions of vaccines. Unemployment is at 6.2%. The clock is ticking on a $1.9 trillion relief bill in Congress. Thursday, the National Guard was deployed to defend the U.S. Capitol against another potential security breach on a day QAnon was hoping Donald Trump would be restored to the presidency. That was 2 days after FBI Director Christopher Wray appeared before Congress to discuss the January 6th insurrection, which left at least five dead, testifying that racially motivated extremism is the biggest domestic terror threat we are facing. And next week, former Minneapolis police officer Derek Chauvin goes on trial for second-degree murder and second-degree manslaughter in the death of George Floyd. In short, there's a lot on our plate right now, and Republicans are focused on a smorgasbord of stupid, a buffet of buffoonery. And look, maybe it's all a distraction, because while they're foaming at the mouths over Dr. Seuss and Mr. Potato Head, they're spending real capital on some truly awful things as well. Texas and Mississippi's Republican governors lifting mask mandates just as we're hoping to turn a corner on COVID. Pushing no fewer than 253 bills in 43 states to make voting harder, in particular for minorities. And continuing to push the big lie that Biden isn't the legitimate president, inciting millions of Trump supporters to potentially undermine our democracy and put the lives of lawmakers in danger. Republicans and right-wing media might be having fun at our expense right now, but history will not be confused about this stupidest of times. History will look back at the Seuss, Potato Head, Neanderthal wars while Americans were dying with utter embarrassment. Okay, that's it for me. See you next week.